Good morning, everybody. Good day. Welcome to Dental Voice on the Case with Zyrus. My name is Rolando Mia. Today, we have a returning guest, a very good friend, a longtime friend, in Dr. Lewis Kaufman. He is the owner of Smile Design Studio in Hyde Park, Illinois, and I'm excited to hear him share with us advice, feedback on how important proven systems, equipment, that type of stuff are in getting consistent outcomes. Good morning, Dr. Lewis. How the heck are you?
Morning, Rolando. I'm doing very well. Thank you. It's actually a little afternoon here in Chicago. I'm doing good. It's been a crazy morning. Like most dentists, you're running around doing a lot of work on a Tuesday. So I'm blessed and thankful for that. So, well, thanks for having me. I appreciate you.
Yeah, really appreciate you joining us again. And every time I spend time with you, I learn something, and I really appreciate it, because in addition to being a clinician, you're also a lecturer. You do a lot. You have an incredible amount of knowledge on systems, and I'm really interested to hear your perspective on systems and kind of what we're going to be talking about today is this whole idea of proven things. So what advice do you want to give us, and how, what do you want to share with us today?
The biggest advice I can is a rule I've taken with me throughout the years is just, you know, keep it simple. You know, don't keep it stupid. Keep it simple, stupid. Or, you know, you remember that adage is you don't want to overcomplicate anything you do, whatever you're doing. In dentistry, certainly you want to stay consistent on that. Use tried and true materials. You know, when we do show the video, you'll see the materials I use day in and day out. On a consistent basis, some of them for 15, 20 years that have just, you know, proven to be very effective in the operation. I don't want different materials and different operatories. The dental team here, my assistants know we use the same thing all the time, doing it the same way each time. And that way, and I learned this from a guy, Bob Ibsen. You remember Bob Ibsen from years ago. Dr. Bob Ibsen, you know, he taught us, you know, have a checklist, do it the same way so it's predictable, efficient, and get the job done and, you know, take care of the patient well for a long time.
Awesome. So what's the case that you're going to show us today, and what's kind of give us a context for what this is about?
So, we threw this bite wing up here just to show, hey, take a bite wing x-ray. You know, we all make mistakes. I make mistakes forgetting to take a bite wing, and boom, you know, there's something like this pops up, and you're like, oh, damn. You know, what did I do? So message to all of us is remember to take that bite wing x-ray after insertion of a crown or a restoration to make sure you, you know, try it in, make sure you got the right fit. So what you're going to now show, what happened here is we cut this crown off and then we went ahead to go ahead and go into delivery. We actually milled this crown in the office. We used Glidewell's milling system to produce it. And right here, this is basically the delivery phase of the procedure. I'm using DenMat's material. It's an acid etch aluminum oxalate. Been using that product in the practice for about 20 years. Just proven durability. If this was a vital tooth, yeah, I have no cases I can remember over all these years any sensitivity because I've used this acid etch along the way. This tooth was cleaned first with Preppies before we went ahead and did this portion of the procedure. I did a Bruxer crown on this case. Again, there's a product, a proven track record of 10 plus years in the marketplace. So again, we acid etched for 20 seconds. You saw me rinse it, blow it dry, don't desiccate the collagen. I'm using the Kurz product, Optibond Solo Plus as the adhesive, putting there on for 15 seconds. Blow it thin slightly so we're not pooling it. That's a real key with all the adhesives to make sure we're not pooling that product. The crown was cleaned with Ivoclar's Ivoclean just to get those phosphates broken down so we have increased bond strength. You're going to see my dental assistant. I mean, she loves this. I mean, Rebecca and I, and you know, we work in harmony with each other all the time. She's already, you know, loading Relyx into the crown. That's DenMat's flashlight that we're using right there. to cure the adhesive resin. And she's going to be handing me the Reli-X here in a second. We're going to insert it. I'm going to hit the buccal and lingual of that crown for a couple seconds each with the curing light. And then you're going to see me use a Montana Jack posterior scaler to clean off the excess and flick it out. And I want you to notice, you know, the isolite's in there and it's really controlling the environment. You know, the tongue's out of the way, the area is dry, it's maintained. And when we're talking about consistency of using materials, I know how each of these materials are going to perform. Again, it's based on the history of using them. It's based on the fact that my dental assistants know what I use, and it becomes just, it comes easy. Bob Ibsen used to use the adage of, you know, it's like flying a plane. You have a checklist and just go through it. Just get it done and go through it. We're just flossing out the contacts here. And then we're going to be pulling the isolite out, having the patient close down a cotton roll for a few minutes. We'll go back in with an explorer. We'll clean it out some more. But just, you know, when we were talking the other day, Rolando, I mean, maybe I take it for granted because I've done this type of work for so long, like many clinicians have, that you just, you know, you fly through it because, one, you planned it out, you know, years ago. You had a checklist of how you wanted to do it. It's like, well, you know, even your setups, you know, like with young dentists, when you're coming out, you know, if you have specific setups you like, you know, photograph those for your dental assistants so they know what you like out there. So again, you saw it was very easy to remove the isolite, have the patient close into occlusion, put a cotton roll in, and then what we're gonna do is we'll go back, we'll check the bite, make sure everything is, you know, locked and loaded. So it's funny, we were talking previously, you know, how much do we use the isolite in the practice? Well, this morning, before I got on the call, we were supposed to have a temporary dental assistant, you know, go figure, you know, we're all short on dental assistants across the country right now. And we're short a dental assistant. I have two associate doctors working, a periodontist working, two hygienists, and we need one more dental assistant. And they didn't show. Called the dental temp company, and they were surprised the temp didn't show. I said, everybody's worried, what are we going to do? I said, pull out the isolate. We have it in every operatory, and we're good to go. And that's how we did it. And I did it. Again, it was an in-house crown this morning on that patient. So awesome tools that you know that are predictable that are going to work. We don't want to make our lives harder. It's hard enough to make dental practice.
Awesome. Thank you for sharing that. What you showed us there looks like it's been done. If you were to highlight like the top issues, problems that you actually face in delivering that kind of restoration, what would those be? And then how do you overcome them?
So the biggest thing is obviously it's going to be contamination of the bonding site of that tooth, your saliva. You need to control that. We don't want the tongue bouncing around, you know. In the old days, patient can have tongue control before isolite, so that would be a problem. The patient, you know, checking things with their tongue, so you run into that. Also, we want to make sure that we've cleaned the prep well. Say, you know, using the preppies, keeping a clean site, a controlled site. That's the biggest issue in all of dentistry. You know, whether we're delivering veneers, crowns, whether we're doing operative. The biggest issue is contamination. It's controlling blood. That's another one besides the saliva. So it's moisture control.
So I noticed in the X-ray, let me bring the X-ray up here. It looks like there's an open margin on there, right? Is that so?
You are
that...
right. Dr. Rowe, you are right.
So how did that happen? Or does that just happen?
So it shouldn't happen, and that happened because when the try-in for that crown was done, X-ray was not taken of that site, a bite wing X-ray. So a bite wing X-ray should be taken on every insertion of any crown. Anything that's going to be cemented in the mouth, we need to do a bite wing X-ray to make sure that we are flush, we have proper emergence profile, so a situation like this doesn't occur. And it's, you know, It's easy, you know.
No, this is not your case.
No, this is somebody that came into the practice.
Wow.
So, yeah, and I have made mistakes, believe me. I mean, this has happened to me, but this wasn't one of mine.
So you had to cut the crown off, and then you had to restore it, and it's this validation. It's interesting. I hear it's about proven, but also it's also about validating what you've done. How do you identify what systems work for you and then what systems you don't use? How do you kind of get there? What advice would you give people about that?
That's a great question. My biggest advice is you know, you got to do a lot of reading in dentistry. You got to do a lot of research. So what I've looked at over the years has been compendium. That's been really big in terms of great science. The other was Gordon Christensen. I followed him since dental school and throughout all the years. And what I like about CR is that it's not funded by dental companies. It's all honest feedback. I'm not saying there's dishonesty out there, but you're getting an honest opinion. Somebody's not paying you for it. And he's just put together, you know, him and Rella Christensen have done a phenomenal job over their careers of being non-biased in evaluating products, in my opinion. And I followed that advice over the years, and it has served me well.
So that's cool. So it's about listening to other people, actually using systems, and then sticking with what works, but also it sounds like keeping an eye out and you know, and listening to people who know what they're talking about. I want to share something here from Tyann. I would agree 100%.
Oh, jeez. Thank you. Making me feel really old. Well, we are old.
No, not at all. So anyway, first of all, really appreciate you taking the time to spend with us here. Really appreciate the advice that you have. By the way, folks, in addition to being clinician, lecturer, Dr. Kaufman is also an administrator for SmileSource. So if you have questions about it, if you have questions about the materials that he's using or the case, please feel free to reach out to him. Dr. Kaufman, what would be the best way for people to connect with you if they had questions?
They can use my email, which is going to be loukauf@gmail.com.
Awesome. Well, first of all, those of you who've seen this, if you like this content, please share it. If you have questions for us, send them to us or reach out to Dr. Lewis. He is an incredible person. Every time I spend time with him, I learn something. Dr. Kaufman, thank you so much for joining us. Thank you for sharing that. I appreciate it. Have a great rest of your week and hope your staffing, you know, you're able to kind of get through your staffing issues and things are great. So
thank you. Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you for having me on, Ro.
All right. Take